his question is, there are a lot of things happen in life, okay? How do I live without getting affected by that? Is the question. Okay. So I didn't get into very deep spiritual this thing. You are not body, mind, intellect, you are atma, nothing like that. I got into some basic this thing. So life, everything is a transaction, practically, right? So when you meet a customer, you meet a customer because there's a in the expectation transaction. He needs something from you need something from him. There's a transaction. Okay. So if the transaction doesn't happen, that relationship doesn't go further. If the transaction happens, then you start seeing how we can build the relationship further. Clear? Mm-hmm. Isn't it? Now, if tomorrow a customer leaves you, will you feel bad about it? It may hurt your business.
Yeah.
Okay? Mm-hmm. But there's nothing good or bad about it. He made his decision about life. He made some transaction. He violated your transaction with somebody else's transaction. Mm-hmm. Where he found that's better, he went there. Mm-hmm. And you probably you get a customer. Tomorrow you find that another more valuable customer is there, you will give less attention to this guy.
Yeah.
Right? Ultimately, the life, what we live, has a lot of transactional content.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? In transactional content, you don't have to feel bad or good or bad about it. As long as the transaction is going fine, it is there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Now from transaction, we switch over to personal. That's where the danger, problem is.
Yeah.
Okay? Transactional to personal, that's a very fine boundary.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, the transaction to personal is, in the transactions, the expectations are very, very clear. What you expect, what you get.
Mm-hmm.
In the personal, expectations are not at all clear. The boundary is very thin.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. For example, you have this lady or your friend who are a friend. There's not much of transaction there. He is a friend because he's a friend. Okay, now in the business life, the transactions are very, very clear. The input and output conditions are in the person, when it comes from transactional to personal, the boundaries are not clear. You don't know what is the expectation, what is the aim. That's where the dangers are. Okay, you have a friend, one day the friend didn't talk to you, then you get hurt. But in transaction, talking to you, not to you, is not a hurt.
Yeah.
Here, the friend even doesn't even know that you should, transaction is the, talking to you is one of the mandatory requirements. And the person says something, not necessarily to hurt you or something, then you get hurt. Because, oh, I didn't expect from you, you are my friend. Are Baba, is there written somewhere that what friends should do, what friends are not do? The do's and don'ts are written. So, there are two conditions. One is where expectations are clear, the inputs and outputs are clear, and personal is where expectations are not at all clear, inputs and outputs are not clear. If you look at your life, the hurt is happening where this unclear area. Am I true? I mean,
mm-hmm.
Right? Where the transactions, the expectations of input and output is very clear, there's no hurt. I mean, you may feel loss, but you don't feel, doesn't burn you. But the moment unclear expectations are there, undefined expectations are there, and you are yet to supposed to fulfill that, they are in trouble. Forget your marriage anniversary. There you are in big trouble. You are not even supposed to know that, you don't even know that marriage, remembering marriage anniversary on the day is very important. It causes burn. Whereas in business it's very clear. The transition is very clear. So, the problem where we get into disturbance is areas where the definitions or the expectations are not very clear. Okay. So, then we have two types of things. One is transactional and other is called non-transactional or personal. Okay. In transactional, you handle it as per the, try to define as much as, so today you are having a business discussion. What you are trying to define is, what is our transition? You are trying to define as much clarity and as much objectivity as possible.
Mm-hmm.
Things are objective, there's not much of hurt happens anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Things which are subjective, there's a problem.
Yeah.
Right? Now the question is, can subjective be made objective? The moment you are able to make subjective as objective,
mm-hmm.
okay, then there is, you will not get hurt by anything. Anything happens, you are not hurt. Can the subjective be objective? And if it's so, how? Is it possible?
I mean, the relationships and everything sometimes are such that I don't know.
See, what happens is we get enmeshed in relationship.
Mm-hmm.
We get entrapped in the relationship. Okay? Relationships are in a way subtly transactional. Subtle.
Mm-hmm.
Business, that it's very clearly, obviously transactional. Mm-hmm. Relationships are very subtle transactions. Okay? I scratch my back, you scratch my back. Mm-hmm. There's one transaction.
Mm-hmm.
You don't expect it.
Yeah.
So you have heard this word called friend. Who is a friend? What is the definition of friend? You know, what is the definition of standard definition of friend? A friend in need is friend indeed. Otherwise, he's not a friend.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, what do you mean by friend in need?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. When I feel like crying, the friend should be ready with the towel. If the friend is not ready with the towel, he's not a friend.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's actually a sudden transaction. Okay. But more undefined. So, in that undefined transaction, we start getting the emotional tangle.
Mm-hmm.
And this emotional tangle which causes hurt. It causes disturbance. Okay, in business we can get hurt. Okay, loss of money can hurt. Loss of customer can get hurt. But the emotions will get disturbed when there is an emotional entanglement. So the business, you should take it more impersonal. Nothing personal about it. Even when you do business with a friend, money is money. Friendship is friendship. They can't mix them two. Right? So, I think these two situations you have to handle separately. The personal relationship is you have to handle in a very different way. You have to learn how to be objective. Not about the other person.
Mm. Yeah.
You have to be objective about yourself.
Yeah.
Please understand. Mm. In business, you have to be objective about the other person and other needs.
Mm.
Whereas in the personal relationship, you have to learn how to be objective about yourself.
Mm.
Okay? You get into trouble because you are not objective about yourself. And you start evaluating the other person, thinking that other person is cause of your trouble. Other person is never a cause of your trouble. Okay? So, if you look, how do you become objective? You look at yourself. Okay, now let me ask you one straightforward question. You don't have to tell the names. If you have to name three people whom you love most, who are they? So you said three people, right? My mom, my daughter, and my dad. What is common to all this? Okay, actually, you are emphasized three times that I love me most. Okay, actually, three times very emphatically you said, I love me most. It's because my mom, my dad, my dad's daughter. Okay, but we fool ourselves. Okay, we fool others also. Hey, I love you so much. We never love others. We love others for the sake of myself.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So now, this is a sort of inverted relationship. I love myself, but I never want to say that I love myself. But I love myself through you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, unfortunately, you have trapped other person also into your love. You can love yourself. What is your problem? Now, the moment you bring other person into the loop, then other person is in trouble. Oh, I love this person, but this person didn't talk to me. You love yourself only. Why you are creating the other person, bringing the time to the other person also into your loop? So what I was saying, we are really not objective about ourselves. Okay? The moment you do that, a lot of subtle conditions will start putting. Subtle, very subtle. Expectations. Now, the love becomes a subtle transaction. Okay, I give something, you give back. I scratch your back, you scratch my back. So it's a complete love has been converted a business. The problem is business is very clear. What is input, what is output is clear. Here there's no input output definition at all. So you cannot ask the other person to define that because the other person has no clarity. You can bring clarity to yourself. You understand everything which I am doing is for my love for myself. Okay. I don't need anybody else's happiness or transaction to make me happy. Okay. So stop expecting something from the other. You see, what I can give to other, the relationship has to be inverted. Okay. Now nobody can hurt you. Nobody can, you, because you are not expecting anything from anybody. On the other hand, you know how to give. And that person may get hurt. I didn't get this from this person, but that's his problem. But your problem is you have a certain undefined expectations. Okay? Stop your expectations. I am happy by myself. I am loved by myself. All that I do is with my relationship with my friends, I always give rather than get back.
Is it easy?
Very easy. That's the easiest way to live.
Every time I tell myself, what did I give in this relationship?
Every time you nourish the relationship by giving, not by getting. That's all is the key. If you are getting hurt, you look at your that hurt. That's because there is something which is not coming back to you. Why? Why you become a beggar? You have to live like a millionaire. I know how to give. I don't want to get anything. Whatever comes, it doesn't matter to me. That richness is there. You are free from all disturbance in life. Otherwise, we live our life, whole life as beggars. We are waiting for something to come from the relationship. A smile from the friend, a message, a phone call, a hi, a how are you?
It's good, right? Sometimes good.
That's what I'm saying. Feel good about yourself. Why you want to make feel good from others? You make them feel good. That's okay. Learn how to give rather than how to get back. Don't expect anything. The moment you expect something from some other person, life you have converted into a business transaction. The moment you converted life into business transaction, life is gone. Life is not a business transaction. Life is about giving. Life is about loving, not because somebody gives you something. In spite of somebody who's not giving something to you, you love. Because you are of the nature of love. If you say, I love my mom, I love my dad, that means I love myself. If you love yourself, why you become these all the indirections? So you understand what is the hitch. The hitch is business transaction, everything is defined. What is input, what is output? You know what to give, and you know that this condition is not met, this is not okay. But in personal life, we have a lot of hidden conditionalities. You cannot help about other person's condition, artist. Let it be so. But you remove yourself, you take a sheet of paper and remove all conditionalities about other person. Free that person from you. Right? You have taken a loan from the bank. When you take the loan from the bank, they pay you, give you 30-page documents. There'll be all small, small, small letters. They'll write so many conditions. You can't escape from any way. Right? And they'll make you sign in every page. Do you have time to read all those conditions? No. They're all hidden conditions. They'll catch you somewhere. Our relationships are like bank statements. There are so many hidden conditions there. You don't know which condition you violate.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. Why you want to keep some person in a loan? Just tear up that conditions. Say you are free. I'm also free. You don't have to give anything, but I give you because that's my choice. Then you'll not get hurt in life. Did I answer your question?
No.
problem in our relationships is the relationships are born out of bondage, not of freedom. Okay? We don't have relationships out of freedom. We don't respect other person. We want to make the other person slave. For that, we have a lot of conditions. A slave is supposed to do certain things in life. Okay, if that doesn't do, you get angry with the slave. You get hurt with the slave. Alright? If you are a master slave, you are. But in a relationship, we create mutual slavery. Okay. In business, we have explicit transactions, what is input and what is outputted. But in relationship, a lot of implicits. The person didn't look at me, oh my God, hurt. Some conditions violated. Out of 30 conditions, one condition violated. The other person doesn't even know what conditions violated. So, you have a document of slavery built into your head. A slave is supposed to do this many. Why? You want to make your relationship as slaves to you. And in the process, you're made slave to somebody else. All relationships you have made into conditional transactions. And the conditional transactions you says you give me happy, gives me happiness. In fact, removing all conditions makes you happy. My love is unconditional. Okay. The moment love becomes conditional, it becomes an attachment. The moment it becomes attachment, both parties who are attached become gets hurt. Right? Very simple thing, no? You have that band-aid, right? Band-aid, you put your hand. Remove band-aid, it hurts because it sticks to your hairs. Attachment hurts. Don't be attached. Be detached. Doesn't mean running away.
Yeah.
Detachment means simply understand that everybody in the world is free. Okay? I should not put explicit or implicit conditions within me expecting them to do something. The moment you do that, it becomes a transaction. Relationships are not transactions. Relationships should be out of love. A love frees a person. If you are getting hurt in relationship, it's because there's attachment. Attachment is not love. Attachment is expectation from that relationship. The moment you put a relationship, you convert into business, it hurts more than business loss. Right? So, simple principle of life. I am free and I want everybody to be free in and around me. The freedom doesn't mean to do whatever is there. Freedom doesn't mean that, it means that I don't expect anything from that. But I will do my best to nourish that relationship. The love knows how to give. Attachment knows how to get. Are you clear? Free the persons. Become free. The moment you attach to somebody, you are also bonded. That doesn't mean that you run away from the person. You become more loving. You become more nourishing. Okay, the moment I said detach, oh, I'm detached, I don't look at the person, okay, tomorrow I don't look at the person, I don't make a phone call, I don't make WhatsApp, I am out. That's not detachment. That's actually a hate. It's the opposite of attachment. That's also attachment. The attachment is the presence or absence doesn't matter. But the attachment means there's pure love. In that pure love, always you have the question, what best I can do? Okay, in attachment, there's always a question, what best other person can do to me? Why you are living a misery life? Like life like a miser. I want this, I want this. A small smile is better, makes me feel good. Why? This person did smile at me, I am feeling bad. Oh, why? You should say, yeah, I am fine, I am okay. So is other person. So, okay, the relationship gets spoiled when you feel that I'm not okay, the other person is okay. Or other person is not okay, I am okay. You say, I am okay, you are okay. Okay, let us meet, let us be friendly. Doesn't mean that we put our neck, put us, this thing, what I got it, tie something to our neck. then this you attitude you bring in your relationships, in your this relation, or even in business, you will not get any disturbed. Does it make sense? One line summary. Never be in relationship. Okay, have relationship but never be in relationship. When you are in relationship, you expect certain things out of relationship. Okay, that is called attachment. A relationship where there is no expectation, there is pure love, there's only question what I can do rather than what should be done to me. If that is your question, you are free. What I can do for you? If that question is there, never ask a question what you didn't do for me. Mm-hmm. What I can do for you, that I'll do out of love. Mm-hmm. And what you can do for me is for love. Why? Why you want to fill up yourself with love? You become full of love. Nourish your relationship.
Love is freedom, expectation is bondage.